G'day, thanks for joining me. Tonight we're going to have a talk about the flight computer, also known as the E6B flight computer. It's one of my favorite navigational tools. I'm going to show you just a few little tricks and things that you can do with them and just to show you why I think it's such a good tool. So enjoy the show. So this is a Jeppesen E6B flight computer. You can buy other brands on eBay and other places fairly cheaply. The metal ones go for about $40. You can buy cardboard ones for less than $20. You can even find on the internet, and I'll put a link down below, to a flight computer that you can print out and stick together. So that's a really cheap way of doing it if you just want to have a play around with one but don't want to have to spend any money. So to introduce the E6B, I should show you some of the main functions and features of it. The flight computer has two main scales on it. It's a logarithmic circular slide rule. It has two scales on it, the outer scale here in on the black and the inner scale here on the silver, and the center wheel here spins around. On the bottom is a temperature conversion scale. Around the inner and outer scales are various conversion items. I'll show you how to use those. On the back is a clear screen with a compass rose and a slidable board which allows you to calculate things like vector calculations, crosswind and off-track calculations, that sort of thing. But tonight the thing we're going to do is to show you how to do some speed, time, distance calculations using this device. When you're a pilot, you've got a lot of things going on and you want to be able to do your calculations very quickly. You don't want to have to muck around with calculators and remembering formulas. So this device does a lot of the calculations for you. If you remember your school mathematics, you'll know that distance equals speed times time. So this circular slide rule will do that calculation for you without you having to calculate it. And I'll show you how to do it for calculating distance, for calculating speed, and for calculating time. So here we go. So speed is calculated as distance divided by time. On this device, whenever you use the black pointer here, it's referring to speed. So to get speed, you need to match up the distance on the black scale and the time on the inner scale. So if we had 360 kilometers we traveled in a period of 2 hours, you can work that out quickly in your head and say, well, it's 360 divided by 2 is 180 kilometers per hour. What you can also do with the E6B is you can take 360 on this outer scale, so 36, and you can take your 2 hour scale on the inner circle, match the two up like that, and then over here you can read it off on the outer scale where the arrow points, and you can see that 360 kilometers taking 2 hours, you will travel at 180 kilometers per hour. So another calculation we'll do is to work out distance. Now distance is speed times time. If we're traveling at 60 kilometers per hour and we travel for a period of 90 minutes, what we do is we take our inner circle and put the arrow on 60 for 60 kilometers an hour, and then we come around to the 90 minute mark and we read that we travel 90 kilometers. And that makes sense. If you're traveling at 60 kilometers per hour and you travel for 90 minutes, you're going to travel 90 kilometers. So that's a really quick overview of the speed, time and distance on an E6B flight computer. You can use this if you're sailing, and you can use it if you're in a car. You can use it pretty much anywhere you like. Anywhere that you would need to do speed, time, distance calculations quickly, you can use this circular slide rule for doing those calculations. I really hope you've enjoyed this presentation. If you'd like it, then please give us the thumbs up. If you would like to subscribe, then please click the subscribe button, and if you've got any comments, then feel free to leave them below and we'll certainly answer them for you. Have a good night and we'll catch you soon. Bye bye.